Like, he's so, his confirmation just, and I love his confirmation. vertical direction as well as horizontal direction. Horizontal direction, we will search eight times, four by the head, four by the loin. We want that nose up underneath that eye, no head up tilting. We don't want to see any whites in the eyes. We want them to make a perfect C around the right of the leg. We want that inside eye stepping out, and the outside eye stepping out, the inside eye stepping up and under the navel. And that's for horizontal direction. And we want vertical direction as well, with selects taking out of the range of the horse. Put the select back in the rein with suppleness to the full and the length. So now I'll begin my circles after checking in with this horse. I'll begin with walking him to the right. Again, I'm asking for horizontal direction and vertical direction as well. If he wants to cut his shoulder in, we're going to take his ribs away from him and ask for a little bit of stage three. Stage three is front hind feet moving together in a lateral motion. If we use stage three to set him back on that line, as to teach him to really ride on those curved lines. Here I'll ask for some stage two. Stage two is the horse pulling itself in reverse motion using a high quarter. Stage four, the inside hind stays down while the other three pivot forward around it. Now we'll do a circle to the left. Again, asking for some horizontal direction as well as vertical direction. Coming up here, I'll ask for some stage two again. Put vertical direction into stage four here. I'll ask for a little bit of a drop. Again, want some horizontal direction and vertical direction. And I also want the horse traveling on a loose rein here.
Good job, Gavin.
I'll ask for some stage two with vertical direction into stage four. Now I'll trot again. Again, asking for vertical direction as well as horizontal direction. Ask for some stage two. There, you kind of want to take a step out, so I'll correct that a little bit, give it a break, and go into stage four here. Now we want to pick up a lope to the right.
Do you think they'll walk in? With our horses? I've been practicing. When did they have a trail?
As for a stop there, stage two, into stage four. Now here I want to ask for a look to the left. Picked up the correct lead.
We picked up the correct lead there.
Horizontal direction, vertical direction.
Woo!
Ask for a stop here. Stage two. And the front hind feet moving together in a lateral motion. We really want that outside hind, taking that inside hind in a lateral motion there. Get stage three. We're going to ask again. Really get this goal. Stage three, I want that hind quarter a little bit better. There we go. There's good stage three. Now we'll ask for stage four. As far as the spin goes, So what I always do is take kind of a tighter circle, kind of some outside leg, outside leg.
Woo!
And let that inside nine really plant and help step around yourself forward there. That was good. Well, that's first. To the left a little bit. Right there. Ask for some stage two. And then now I'll kick a cow out for my.
Dude, Gavin, I think you can play guitar. You gotta see that colt when I picked him up. He had blood balls.
All right, whenever you guys are good.
Right, so you were saying, what was the strength weakness? What do you like about the colt?
The thing that I like, I really like this colt's softness. He didn't really show it today. Any other given day, I'll bet he would have showed way better. But when you do check this colt up and take the time to do your groundwork and everything, he's super soft, and he wants to come into your hand, and he wants to please you. The thing that I don't like about him is, I'd say probably a temperament thing. You know, he seems like he's from the get-go, he's been kind of a grumpy horse, kind of hasn't really wanted to really work that hard, and so that's kind of a deal I've been messing with him, with putting more pressure on him and things like that. Of course, with temperament like this, it's a little bit more hard, a little more difficult to put that pressure on that horse, but he seems like a pretty smart colt. I've enjoyed riding him. So I would be a lot more confident.
good on the front of the car. He's a little more iffy on the back. But whenever you go to turn your shimmer in, you do, I always rub this kind of leg and get in gear first before I do it. Average bolt stuff, not pulling back or anything like that. You know, I haven't noticed him. He likes to stand there quiet. He doesn't haul or anything. So,
what about hobble? Have you hobbled him?